Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today I'm gonna show you how to edit your footer in WordPress.com. WordPress.com, the hosted version of WordPress, includes footers for many of its themes, with options to remove or change the footers with a few clicks. The methods for editing footers in WordPress.com are similar to how it's done in the self-hosted WordPress.org version, but with a few differences. Of course, before we get too deep into the differences, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's get started. You must log in to your WordPress.com dashboard and manage your footer in the theme customizer. Luckily, many of the themes offered for WordPress.com are similar or exactly the same as what you'd find for WordPress.org. However, that also means the way in which you edit the footer in WordPress.com depends on which theme you install. To begin, go to Appearance, then Customize in the dashboard. Look at the Theme Customizer tabs available for that particular theme. Most themes have a Widgets tab, but you must figure out if a footer area for placing widgets is provided with your theme. Click on the Widgets tab to find out. This current theme we're using provides a footer widget module. If you don't see an option to put widgets in the footer, consider trying a new theme or use menus instead of widgets. For this example, with a footer widget area, click on the Add a Widget button. A slide-out menu appears with a collection of widgets. You can select whichever widget makes the most sense for your company. Again, the theme dictates how many widgets you can fit into the footer without it looking too cluttered. It appears this particular theme allows for about 3 columns of widgets before the design starts looking messy. For our example, we'll choose a contact info and map widget along with a follow blog widget, which prompts visitors to sign up with their email addresses. The preview on the right shows the widgets in action. We recommend going through each widget settings panel to configure individual elements like the display text and choose which fields you want to show in each widget. Make sure you click on the Save Changes button so the widgets appear on the front end of your website. You may also notice that WordPress.com automatically adds your site title and a WordPress credit at the very bottom of your footer. You can usually get rid of the site title if you want, but the WordPress credit removal requires you to pay for the business plan. To modify both of these elements, click on the Site Identity button. First, go to the bottom of the settings to find the footer credit field. Click that dropdown to reveal all possible options. Every one of the credits has some sort of reference to WordPress. A WordPress credit isn't a big deal if you're running a personal blog or online journal, but we suggest you upgrade to the business plan and remove the credit if your site is for a legitimate business. After that, you can click on the drop-down menu and choose the Hide option to get rid of the credit completely. The credit then disappears in the preview, leaving whatever widgets you added to the footer along with the site title. Some themes have the ability to remove the site title from the footer as well. The easiest way is to uncheck the Display Site Title and Tagline box. That gets rid of the site title in the footer and potentially the header. For the header, we recommend uploading a logo anyway. Other themes have different ways of removing the site title and tagline. Sometimes it's not possible at all, while other times the site title isn't included in the footer to begin with. When in doubt, try deleting what's inside the site title field if you don't have the display site title and tagline checkbox. Another way to insert content in your WordPress footer is by utilizing the menus panel. Not all themes allow for menus in the footer, but it's a good idea to at least check. Click on the Menus tab to continue. Select View All Locations. This brings up a list of where you're allowed to place menus in the particular theme. For our example theme, we have quite a few menu location options, one of which is for the footer. You won't be so lucky with every theme you encounter, so be prepared to either swap them out or consider using the widget technique for editing your footer instead. With themes that support footer menus, click on the footer drop-down field. We chose a pre-made social menu for this footer. Feel free to select the Create New Menu link if you don't already have a suitable menu. The result is a simple text link menu that appears above whatever widgets you already added to the footer. It's possible you're unable to add widgets to your theme, so you may not see the exact same format. Keep in mind that all menus are simply lists of text and links, so you won't be able to incorporate something like a social media icon menu unless you consider a separate plugin that supports that. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.